This video covers the use of the DDK tungsten carbide knife for facing off your block after rough trimming. Generally, no matter how good you are, it's very difficult when using a razor blade for facing off, getting down to the tissue, to keep the block face flat and defect free. Obviously, it depends on the sharpness of your razor blade and your skill, but it always is very difficult to get everything flat at 0 degrees for a knife and specimen arc. So to prevent these mistakes, I use sharp razor blades and rotate it 90 degrees so I can see the side. I'm pretty well done with my rough trimming, and now it's time to face off. Typically, we have either a glass knife or a diamond or a tungsten carbide knife. The problem with glass is the back of it is slightly curved, and so then your block face has a curvature to it. One thing nice about this tungsten carbide knife, the DDK, is that it's flat across the back. And that way then your block face is planar, so when you cut it with a diamond, it doesn't have edge and curvature to the block face. So this loads just like a regular glass or diamond knife. We're going to put it in there. This knife does ask for a 10 degree clearance angle, so we're going to set that, and that's a little bit higher. Just remember to reset your clearance angle back when you put in a diamond knife for thin sectioning or a glass knife. So now that's ready. Let's take a look at our facing it off. I've loaded my rough trimmed block into the ultra microtome and advancing my knife. And we can see it's a nice straight line across there, whereas sometimes you get a little bit of a half moon curvature for glass knives. So what we're going to do is adjust my specimen rotation for my leading edge. It's not real critical at this point since we're just facing off, but it's always good to be as accurate as possible. Now, as we approach this, the block face isn't nice and reflective, so I can't see a reflection of the knife to the block face. But so I'm just taking a little bit of extra time, and I'm going to start facing that off and sectioning, advancing slightly. I always take a lot of little sections versus a few big ones. And now I've faced it off a little bit more, and I had one little pullout in there, and I noticed that that's pretty well gone by now. And so I'm going to take one more section and then check my block face and see what that really looks like. So that looks pretty good. And if I just bring that right back up and take a look at the block face, I'll see that there aren't any pits to it. There's no defects. There's some knife marks and such left over from the knife, but that's to be expected. But it's all nice and planar and ready for trimming down for thin sectioning. Thank you very much.